Hey, what's going on, guys? My stripped lower, the Franken-gun lower, finally came into my FFL today from Palmetto State. Everything seen here is from Palmetto State Armory, and I would like to just say once again a big thank you to Timmy B. MN right here on YouTube. I did win a giveaway of his for a $500 Palmetto State gift card, and that's just totally, totally awesome of him. And so everything seen here was bought with that gift card. The Franken gun stripped lower, the lower pistol build kit, the SBA 4 pistol build kit with the buffer tube, and a 10.5 inch Palmetto State AR-15 pistol upper chambered in 5.56, and I did also get a armorer's wrench, an AR-15 armorer's wrench. So everything seen here will be on the pistol build. You know, obviously the upper is complete, but I will be building the lower. And just once again, Timmy B. MN, if you're not familiar with him here on YouTube, go check him out. Great, great dude. Link in the description to his channel. I can't make it any easier than that for you. So anyway, we have the pistol kit here, SBA 4. I just want to go through some other parts I will be adding to the build. Little items I have, little, you know, whatever I need. So I'll start with the simple stuff, some roll pin punches, a little hammer. I really dig this hammer. It's sort of handheld, you know what I mean? It's nice and small. You can get a little precision work on that. So I dig this tiny little handled hammer. I did get this from Harbor Freight. Cool, very cool little hammer. Okay, I did get an M-Lock angled foregrip, a Magpul M-Lock angled foregrip for it. Can't do without the bad lever. I did get a bad lever for it. I love the bad levers. Iron sights. These are from J&E Machine Tech. They're flip-up front and rear sights. These were sent to me from the Crazy Scotsman. Link in the description to his channel also. They're just standard flip-up front and rear sights that will be going on there. I have this trigger. This is the Ultramatch 2.5 pound drop-in trigger will be going in there. To go with that, I do have some anti-walk trigger pins to go with that. So the 2.5 pound drop-in trigger and the anti-walk pins. As an optic, I did pick up a Monstrum Tactical low profile quick release Picatinny rail for up top, and the Fiocchi 22. I can't remember what the the Fiocchi RDS 22 micro red dot. That will be going onto the Monstrum Tactical Low Pro Quick Release Picatinny rail. So we'll see how that pans out. Also, in the lower build kit, I did get a trigger guard assembly here. But the Crazy Scotsman also had sent me a while back this Gun Tech enhanced trigger guard. which is way cooler looking. He did send it to me to use on a different build, but I wound up not using it, and I will be using it now. Link to Crazy Scotsman also in the description. Go check him out. So yeah, I'm going to be dumping the Magpul trigger guard that came with it and the Magtech, Guntech, I'm sorry, trigger guard will be going on. And, oh, the muzzle device. The muzzle device on the upper is a standard A2 flash hider. And I did go with this is a flash and sound forwarder for it. So I will be replacing the A2 flash hider with a sound and flash forwarder. Also picked up a little pack of crush washers. And I think that's about it. So, yeah, I'm going to get started on this build. And give me a minute, and I'll be right back. Hey, what's going on, guys? Got the AR pistol build. I'm gonna put two magazines through it. It's raining out here, so I'm not staying long. I don't want to get this bitch wet, but let's check it out. Everything seems to be functioning well. Let's give it a shot. Like we had a failure to feed. Good.
Okay, we got an issue here. The magazine's not seating well. It's locked in. A different magazine. All right, looks like we're having some issues feeding here. So I'm gonna have to figure that out. But thanks for watching.
So guys, as you can tell, I am having a few feeding issues with this thing, but nothing that won't be, you know, rectified. But yeah, I'm going to get cracking on the issues on this thing. I don't know if it's being overgassed or I don't know what's going on with it, but I will get to it. I'll get to the bottom of the problem and I'll keep you guys updated. Thanks for watching and thanks again, Timmy BMN. And I'll talk to you guys soon. Thanks.